My name is Cooper White. For my Eagle Project, I want to raise money to give back to Emery County Search and Rescue. 5 years ago, when I was 8 years old, I was camping in San Rafael Swell with my parents and my grandparents. This is a place we went to often, one of my favorite places to ride, hike, and camp in. It was Memorial Day weekend. We had spent the day on Saturday hiking, exploring old mines, and waiting for my grandparents to arrive. When they did, we quickly helped them unload and went for a short evening ride to a lookout and found the wild burros that roam the area. We had a campfire when we got back and enjoyed the sunset. The next day, we headed out to explore an area we hadn't been before. We went through familiar areas past Swayze's cabin, then explore out around a new loop coming back through Eagle Canyon. The day was pretty and we were having fun. At the bottom of the canyon, the trail climbs out and back on top. At the base, we all got out. The trail was a little sketchy and we wanted to be safe. My grandpa and my dad made it up just fine and we all got back into the UTVs. As we approached the last little climb out of the canyon, my parents rode up the hill before we did, and my grandpa followed up behind. Something happened. The vehicle stopped, hopped, and then tipped on its side and started to roll. I remember the first few rolls, then nothing. The vehicle we were in rolled 30 yards, then off a 100-foot cliff. It landed right side up at the bottom of the canyon. Three of the passengers remained in the vehicle. My seatbelt failed, and I was ejected. My grandparents died at the scene, my cousin injured, and I was in critical condition. Emery County Search and Rescue were the first ground crews to respond to our 911 call, along with AirMed. I was life flighted in one helicopter and my cousin in another. The Emery County Search and Rescue team helped my parents and brother out of the area. Part of the team stayed with my deceased grandparents, retrieved all of the camping gear and vehicles, and had to remove my grandparents' UTV via helicopter. After the accident I was in, they kept in touch with my parents for several weeks, came to my grandparents' funeral, which was 3 hours away, and dedicated their main fundraising triathlon in honor of my grandparents. Emery County Search and Rescue covers the fourth largest county in Utah, 4,460 square miles, containing the Manti National Forest and the San Rafael Desert. The area is a popular recreation area. 92% of the county is composed of public lands, state, forest, and BLM. Recreation activities include ATV trails, single track, jeep trails, hiking, mountain biking, and sightseeing. Emery County Search and Rescue is composed of 42 volunteers who volunteer their time, equipment, and expertise of the area and rescue skills. Their ages range from 21 to 70. Their occupations range from probation officers to mine workers to school employees and to mechanics and power workers. They stay busy all year. The team averages one phone call per week. During 2017, they had over 100 call-outs for services. The year was the second highest call-out of the public safety helicopter. Only Salt Lake County had more. A rescue with a chopper costs between $5,000 to $10,000. Without a chopper, each call costs between $2,000 to $5,000. For example, a rope rescue is very expensive. With the stress and strain on the ropes, they usually destroy at least one rope per rescue. The rescue ropes cost more, as much as $1,000 per rope. Of the 42 volunteers, 12 compose the rope team. Each member is equipped with the basic rope rescue tools, which cost about $3,000 per member. They also have EMTs, first responders, and wilderness responders. Most of their calls happen on Saturday night or Sunday morning. Just one popular hiking area gets 20,000 hikers a year. Their services run 365 days a year in all types of weather. The calls range from body recoveries, broken bones, lost people, dehydration, hypothermia, etc. Without these amazing people who spend countless hours, time, and their own money helping others, my situation would not have turned out very well. We go down to support their fundraising triathlon every year, but they need more help. I'm asking you to help me to help them. to help them respond to others found in situations they never thought could happen. If you can, please donate on the GoFundMe link. Any amount will be greatly appreciated. If you would like to be a sponsor for their annual triathlon, please send a message to CW Eagle Project at gmail.com. Thank you.